So I've got a guessing game here, and now when I type in letters, it says that your guess must be a number, so it's doing some advanced input validation and error handling. I can also put in negative numbers. The guess should only be between 1 and 10, so it'll tell the user. For example, if I input something greater than 10, guess must not exceed 10. And also when I press cancel, it just closes. And when I press the close box up here, it just closes. So that's what we're going to be making in this pair of screencasts. I already had a guessing game sub where the program chooses a random number n. We then ask the user for a guess between 1 and 10. And it keeps going until the user guesses n. The flowchart for that is shown here. Just by noticing the space available on this flowchart, all the wide open space, you can imagine we're gonna make some improvements to this. But this is the flowchart. We start, we choose n, we get g, that's the guess from the user. If g equals the random number that was chosen by the program, then we message box something like congrats. Otherwise, we go back up and we get a new guess. The first improvement we're gonna make that you guys have learned about is how to make sure that G is between 1 and 10 inclusive. So shown here, after we get G, we want to make sure both of the conditions, G greater than or equal to 0 and G less than or equal to 10, have to be true. And if that's the case, then we move on and we do the game, the guessing game. If at least one of these conditions is false, then we're going to go in and we're going to check which one is it. Is G greater than 10? If that's true, then we're going to message box maybe something like invalid entry, your guess is greater than 10. Otherwise, if it's false, then we check to see if G is less than 0. If that's true, then we have a message box something like your guess was less than 0. Please try again. In either case, we go back up to the loop. We ask the user for another guess. What we're doing here is making a major modification. The rest of the modifications here are all going to be made to this line. So we have this outer do loop, which is the main structure of the game. Then we have this inner do loop here, which is all the input validation that we're going to be doing. Inside the inner do loop, we get G, the input from the user. And then we ask ourselves, is G less than or equal to 10 and greater than or equal to 0? If that's the case, then we exit the do and we move on to the rest of the game. So if we don't satisfy both of those conditions, then we check to see if G is greater than 10. If that's the case, we're going to message box something like guess must not exceed 10. Please try again. Otherwise, if G is less than 1, we're going to message box something like the guess must not be less than 1. Please try again, and we move along. Let's see how it's working. We just protected it for numbers that are less than or equal to 0 and greater than 10. So let's run through this. If I put in something like negative 9, and we run through that, you see that it bumps down into this, and it says the guess must not be less than 1. Let's reset this and run it when, let's check to make sure that greater than 10, 19, it bumps in there and says guess must not exceed 10. Try again. There's a problem, however. Now, if the user does something that doesn't make sense, like they put in hi, or they just put in letters, it brings up this error box. And if you don't have the editor open, you're just working in Excel, it'll actually open up the editor, which is very unprofessional. It's intimidating to the user, especially if they don't know anything about programming in VBA. So you want to try to minimize that as best as possible. Another thing, this input box pops up and you just press something like cancel. It does the same thing. One way to deal with this, it's sort of just a catch-all. If there's any sort of errors that occur, you can use this onError goto statement. So I've set that up. I've put this onError goto here at the very top underneath my dim statement. If there's any sort of error in the code, it's going to bump to a bookmark, basically a bookmark that you define called here. So it's going to bump down to the bottom here. I have here with a colon. And after that, I put a message box, an error has occurred. Now importantly, if there isn't an error, it's going to go through here fine. It's going to output this message box with the congratulations. And if you don't have an exit sub statement here, it'll tell them that there's an error anyway. So this exit sub just kind of bypasses that message box. So now when we run this, I can put in something that doesn't make sense, like a string or something. and you see that it bumps down and it says an error has occurred. Now it doesn't, it's not more specific than that. It just tells them that an error has occurred. If I just click the OK button without any sort of stuff in there, it's going to do the same thing. It bounces down and tells them that there's an error. So what I've shown here is fine for many applications. Now, if you want to really delve deeper into identifying the different things, for example, letting them know that they didn't put anything into the input box, letting them know that it canceled, and so on, then we can make improvements to this. And so that's what we're going to do next. The next improvement we're going to make is if they enter an integer. So here, you notice that if I put in an integer like 7.5, that if I open up the locals window down here, it actually converts that, it rounds it to an integer. So it rounded 7.5 up to an 8. But maybe we want to let them know that they have to enter an integer and it can't be a non-integer. So let's make improvements to this. The first thing we do is now we have to have three things satisfied. G has to be greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 10, and a non-integer. So I added one little line there. All three of those have to be true in order for us to exit and continue on with the guessing game. I've added in this other test, so we want to identify which of the three of these was not true. So we test to see if G is greater than 10, less than 0, and now we see if it's a non-integer. If it's a non-integer, then we're going to message something like, your number is a non-integer. And then all these come back together, and we go back up to complete the loop. First of all, in order for us to differentiate between an integer and a non-integer, I have to change the data type of G to a double. Next, now we've got here in the flowchart three conditions that have to be true. We've added on the non-integer. So I'm going to add in onto this line, we have to have three things that are satisfied. And I'm adding in, there's this, you can take the integer part of a number, and then we're going to convert it to a string because whatever's input into a input box is treated as a string. So we're going to see if the integer part of G is equal to G itself. This is only going to be true if G is an integer. I've added in one more else if to see if G is a non-integer, so we can identify the error that's involved. And we have a message box, guess must be an integer. So the code worked just fine before we did all this, but it just didn't identify that the user was inputting a non-integer. So let's go ahead and just let me show you what happens when we run through this. If the user inputs something like 7.5, then that's all three of these are not satisfied now because the integer part is not equal to the G itself. So we bump down and this is identified as being a non-integer. So then it outputs, guess must be an integer. Please try again.